Hey everybody, welcome back. This is the Ridiculous Kid 52. But today I'm gonna be turning my channel into like more of a fishing channel, and like I'll do a little bit of gaming, but I'll do fishing mostly. So today I'm gonna go through tackle stuff, a tackle bag. Almost every fisherman probably has them. More pliers. And I got this Rapala fishing thing. It's like to cut your line and stuff. So that's probably useful. Everything I have in this, I have this little spinner bait, this chartreuse color. If you like closely, you can see all the sprinkles and then a little spinner right there. And then I've never caught this on any fish because it's kind of small, but I might have, I just don't remember. I wasn't going to go through this. It's like, it's a Rapala. It's a perch-shaped rattle trap with treble hooks. I don't know if you can hear that, but it rattles. And then, let me move on to this. This is a Shad X-Wrap Rapala. It's fairly new. It's pretty nice, though. I kind of like it. It's not a rattle trap, though, like that one. And we'll sit on to this. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of these. They're called Meps Minnows. No, they're from a story where this kid, he's in a pike fishing tournament with his dad, and he has one of these, and he throws this on and he catches the biggest pike and wins the tournament. Biting Fluffy on my cat up there. His name's Fluffy. And I got a little spinner bait by Buzzer. I call it a buzzard though. It's got that. Makes a lot of noise in the water. I'm pretty sure I've caught a fish on this before. And I got this, which is a little bass stopper. It's like dirty worm color. And then, yeah. Okay, and then I'll move on to my second box. This isn't all the tackle I own, but this is just like the stuff I eat. So, in here, I have pretty sure it's supposed to imitate a wounded fish. It's a chartreuse and greenish color, and then it's a rattle trap. I've actually caught three bass on this. That's why I really like rattle traps. They're really nice for bass. I got this little 1/8 old Cleo. It works pretty well. I've caught some fish on it. Now I'm going to go over to an old Rapala. I don't really use it, but I can see it's caught fish because if you look at the hooks, they're kind of bent a little bit, so maybe. And then I got this, which is the Meps 3 Comet. And it's like almost the same as the other one. It's just this is a rainbow trout, and the other one was a, like, minnow. Another one was a Mets 5. Here's a little fly. Well, I don't use this. It's just my papa died, and he had a tackle box. He liked fishing, so I kind of got all his fishing stuff. I got this one. It's kind of weird. I got two of these. Both little Cleos. This is a Cleo with Legula girl. That's weird. And this one is a Lure Jensen crocodile. It doesn't say that. I just don't know how to pronounce it. I got this little bell right here. Something. It's really cool. Okay. Didn't show you. I have a couple baits left over. That I left in there, but I didn't show you those because the plastics and all my plastics are in the thing. So I like this one a lot. It's like, it's supposed to replicate a little bluegill. I've never caught a fish on it, but it works. I'm pretty sure it works. I like it. And then, I like this one a lot. It's like big bill. Oh no. It's a crayfish, but it has a big bill. And then at the bottom, it is a deep shad or red shad 07. I don't know half what that means, but. And then I've actually caught some big something. Sunfish on this. They'll like come up from behind and like all three hooks got in their mouth. Like perfect. Like the bluegill were probably about this big. Might not look too big. They were trying to get rid of that like layer. Good check the door. Then this perch lure. It's not made for perch. It might be. I don't know. But it's like a little tiny perch. Tiny one. It's got hooks. And this one's pretty new. And then I got this, which is a rattle trap too, but I don't really know what it is or where it's from because I found it. And I got this little thing. This is a rooster tail. Rooster tail, C-74, I think, that's what it said. I'm pretty sure this is for trout. This little camera, I don't really know what it's for, or what it actually put it is, but that's nice. It's not a rattle trap, but it's cool. And I think one box left. Oh no, but I do have this one spinner there. Okay. Oh yeah, I do have the box left. This is like another box. Okay. So here I have one right there, so little paddle. Okay. And this one is a little, pretty sure it's a daredevil on the spoon. And then we're gonna move on to this bait. I actually found this one in a tree. I was like canoeing down the Flint River. And they cut their line like really far out, so I was already wet because I had to push us out. And I saw it, so I'm like, "Oh, I might as well go get that." And I found this and two other lures. I just don't have them with me. I found a old Finland Rapala, which is it's for perch. I mean, not perch. You could probably catch perch on it. It says old. It says Finland Rapala, but it is a jig and wrap. and then it's for walleye. And this one was not a rattle trap, but oh, it is. I didn't know it was. And then it's a jointed. I've caught a bass on this before too. This is my favorite one. I've never caught a fish on it, but I know it's really good. This is a Lunker Hunt Frog Flex. So, when you don't know how it works, so when you, like, it's like a jerkbait kind of, but you'll reel a little bit, and you'll jerk it, and then, like, the legs will hop, and then the fish will, like, the frog will jump. And here I got another rattle trap. Yeah. Now we're gonna move on to my soft plastics. Okay, neck. Kind of stuck to hurt. Here I have a Lunker Hunt. Put on core strength, and then I'll show you what it feels like. Flies in here. All I hear is bzzz. Okay, so these are scented. I'm like, fish will like them, but human, pretty smelly. Yeah, smell like rotted Pringles. I don't know. That's just a random guess at what smell like to me. Watermelon color, 6-inch, 10-pack. These are pretty much all the plastics in here from Best Pro. And this is a Havoc. It's a hole in it. The Berkeley Havoc Sick Fish Junior. It's a 3-inch. Fish. You can see it right there. Fish. Now, we'll move on. My favorite one. My favorite soft plastic that I will always use for bass. There's a bass right there, and you can't see it. Well, you can see it, but does not want to come after it. Anything else, use one of these. These are awesome. I want to give a shout out to KVD, Perfect Plastics. I'm not sponsored by them, you could probably tell, but they are awesome. I love them. Plastics, awesome, especially these ones. These ones I'd say would be my favorite. They look black and with blue sparkles, but get them in the water, or you can see right now they're kind of red. These are my favorites, and I'll tell you why. It's because I'll get one out, but they are really awesome. So these are my favorite. So I want to tell you about this one. So I was fishing with my dad over at this one bridge, and like I had that sunfish on. I was throwing because, like, the river was really shallow, but then there was a creek that came out and was really deep. It was really deep there. And there was a log that fell, too. So, I was really mad and I saw a bass get up. And, like, it didn't go after it, but it saw it. And then, which I'm like, oh, I'll try it. I tried a couple other things. And I'm like, ooh, I know what it'll work. And, because these are coffee. They're with coffee scent and salt. So these smell awesome, and fish love them. So what I did is I put on a Texas rig. I threw it down there. I threw it right where I saw the bass, And I thought there was only one bass, but then three bass came after it. Three. And it was a decent sized largemouth, pretty good. And then it was, I don't have a picture of it because I didn't have my phone, but it's because of the scent. That's what I really like about the KVDs. They're awesome. Very, very awesome. I will go over my rod and reel setup, but I don't have a good reel, which I'm going to be getting one very soon. Because, I'm not, saying any hate to them, but, Mitchell reels, it's like, I went to go fishing out in my pond one day, and my reel was just locked up, would not move, and it's a spinning reel, so I'm not saying any hate on them, but I'm not going to get one of those again. But, I do have a ugly 6GX, too, which is really nice. Favorite one other than the KVD, this catches the giant fish, the bag. No, I'm just kidding. I just had this because I found a cricket and put it in there. So we're looking at these little golf thingies. They're little 1-inch minnows, chartreuse shad, little things like that. Oh wait, I forgot to tell you what KVDs are. They're finesse worms. Blue fleck, 6.5 inch. Okay. Really good. I like it. These, which I have caught my TV on. These are Best Pro Shops Tournament Series Heavy Salt. 7-8 up. This is Senko Worm, 6 inch. Is this 6 inch? 5 3/8 inch. Green pumpkin. In my PV, I don't know what the weight was, but I'm pretty sure it was 4 pounder. Or maybe 5 pounder. This is a green pumpkin Senko. Little chartreuse at the end. I caught 16-inch bass on here. Pretty sure it was my PB. I don't remember catching any bass bigger than that. And there is one thing I have to get is scared. Fluffy, where are you going? And I do like scary. There's a lot of stuff. I like Gary Yamato baits. Can't say his name right, but I like these baits a lot. They're really nice. Here's these. Okay. Alright, so they got a scent too. Salt on them, which is nice scent. I like it. And they're a 5-inch swim Senko. It's a watermelon red and green. Really cool. Like these things, paddle tail. It's really nice. I like them. And my next one, which is my Zoom Bait Company. These are super salty, super flukes, white pearl. The reason I got these is because every time I go up north with my dad, we go to my uncle's, my aunt and uncle's, and they have a boat, and there's this one lake called Fool Lake, and there's the thing you'll mostly catch is pike. And my cousin uses these, which are awesome. The pike love them. Okay, so there are a couple more things. I'll go through another buzzer and a spinner. But, okay, now on to the smallest bait, and I got something other to go over to. These are the Best Pro Shop Tournament Series. They're like the other basketball ones. They're just different. Kind of different colors and stuff. The single one. 16 pack, it's a 6-inch, it does not say the color, but I can make one up on a guess. Yeah, pretty thick too, smell good. Pretty thick, if you look at that, it's pretty thick for a worm, plastic worm. It's like, it has red sprinkles. Yes, I'm calling it sprinkles. I know that's not the correct term, but that's what I call it. And, like, on the belly, it's a little, like, light, dirty brown. On the top, it's, like, a dark, dirty brown. That bullshit. No. Those, like, I like all those baits. So, I'm going to suggest something that you might want to get with you. Really good fishing line, like fishing, are some pliers. These pliers, they're good, but they aren't the best. I like to go with these pliers, medical pliers. What are you going after? But my, you can like helps because you can stick it farther in down and it's like small. Now we're going to work on to this thingamajiggy, which is has a line cutter, pretty much nail clippers, then it's got a hook and a knife. And now we're going to move on to other things that maybe I think everybody should have, is a tape measure or one of these. I like these. Pretty good. Pull it out. Oh, look, I found a 35 inch pipe. This big, almost the size of me. Now, throw that out. End of the video, so I might change my channel name, maybe not, but this is Addictive Skid 52 signing out.